Hi and welcome Optic Rocks fans to this nice tutorial. We will have this example. We will have a light source on the left. That will be this one. And yeah, this is, it's collimated and just a planar wave. And now we have two light pipes. One light pipe is this, it's called B shell or something else. And this other one is here like the cylindric one. And in this tutorial, we want to shape from this light. We want to have a ring, a halo, and we will show this step by step. Okay, like I told you, we have like this is a combination, this lens or this freeform shape of this shell and this this pyramid, and we have some NURB points or some control points, and have in mind the red one are the fixed control points, and the green one are the changing control points. That means like we have in this example an X, Y, we have three control points we are changing. This one for the shell and this one for the pyramid. Have this in mind. Here's an overview how they will change. Like for the pyramid, they change backwards, forwards, and left and right. And also for the shell, back and forwards, left and right. And this CP1 is just moving back and forwards, not left and right. Also have this in mind, here are the lower parameters. With every optic simulation, you should have nice boundaries, because if the boundaries are not right, then it's difficult to get a good solution. And also it makes sense, because you have to manufacture this lens in type of housing, and you need some reduced space or some limited space. Okay, thanks, and let's have some hands on. All right, perfect. I opened here the example, and just we will have a brief overview. Here will be the first light source. And that is the source we want to shape, or we want to have on we want to have as a result. And we did here an embedded script. That means at this point, special thanks to Tom Davis. He's the creator of this tutorial, and also of this example. Thank you very, very much. Just to have in mind, he's doing calculation, and also they're just also doing homogenization, and then they're doing the difference between these two results of this sources. That means like they're looking for the difference of the outcome of the two examples. Have this in mind if you're doing the calculation. And now we will have a brief look at the optimizer, at the definition. Maybe we go on the curve, that you see how this will be changed. Here's the NURB surface, and here are the control points. For example, if I'm changing this, here's the curve, and I change this to -1. For example, just apply, and you see how this will be lower. And also, there's the weight. I can weight this to 2. You see how this will change. Maybe, for example, like do this at 7, and you see this shape will be changed. All right. Also, for the second surface, for this shell here, this can be also like changed like this. I think this helps you a lot. That you have this in mind, for example, minus 0.25. Alright. Also, the boundaries are defined. This is more like down there. Here are the lower limits, the upper limits, and then the fractal steps, that are the minimum steps he's doing. Now we're used the scripted operation. This is this embedded script here, And also this evaluation example should be on the time surface. Now we have multiple starts, and before I want to calculate both examples. Now it's one here and one is down here, and we just will do our analyzation of the timed surface, just with the speed function, the time. And this is now we're starting with our calculation. And yeah, I think we will just run this optimization. Now you see how this is changing. Just calculate this. Here we go. Here's our result. We're just calculating this, then analyze iteration speed function, the time, and yes, move it to our surface visualization view. I'm showing visualization view. Smooth it. Alright. Yes, thanks for watching, and please comment under this video below what topic else you're interested. Thank you very much, and see you in the next one.